Stephanie Cole, plays Marion, of course, in Scarborough, joins me now. 50 years you've been doing this, I guess, more than
since
that?
Since I was 17, yeah.
Oh, wow, yeah, that is amazing, amazing. And you say that Scarborough's a gem of
all. Oh, I love it. Yes, it is. I love it. I mean, when I read the first script, and it changed slightly since then, I thought, this is heaven on wheels. Oh. This is lovely. And I adored Marion, because she's such an old grump. And so,
it's great to play
and
that part.
She's great. Yes, huge
fun. Say whatever
fun.
She likes.
I can, actually.
Yeah.
Mind you, I do anyway. But, yeah.
So no, it's good. And obviously, Catherine Tyldesley, who... You were in Corrie at the same time, but not many scenes, I would have thought.
I don't think we
didn't
have actually any scenes. Because she recently joined, and I was about to go.
I mean, I know you've done really dramatic roles in your career, and really funny ones, too. And I always think comedy's harder. I don't know if that's
true.
Of
course it is.
Yeah.
You know, there's a wonderful story about Molière, the great... You know, French playwright was dying, and a friend came and said to him, "How are you feeling? How is it?" Mm. And Molière said, "It's easier than comedy."
which is
the truth. You know, we all go, "Oh, wow," when somebody does, you know, an amazing Hamlet, and quite rightly,
absolutely,
of course, we do. But actually, what's really hard is to do comedy.
Yeah, and to make people laugh.
I don't mean... I mean, stand-up, of course, is another thing
altogether.
I mean, I think I'd have to shoot myself before I...
Oh, I could never do that. I could never do that. I don't know how they manage
being
it.
Being sick in the wings. It'd be
terrible.
Yes.
Now, we were talking about Corrie, obviously.
Yeah.
Now, Sylvia's kind of back. I know she was killed off,
yes,
but because there's a new storyline happening that apparently Sylvia was a bit naughty and had another child.
Oh, really?
And Roy's going to meet his long-lost brother.
Oh, how lovely.
Which is very nice.
Oh, that's sweet.
Well, we hope it's all going to turn out well.
Oh, I do hope so.
Especially for
David's
Roy.
So sweet. Yes, absolutely.
We really do. It's interesting as well, you were talking about, like, nerves and things.
Yeah.
Because stage fright is, I think, something that I would imagine every actor goes through.
Well, I think everybody at some time or another, actually.
And it's a scary, scary thing. Even someone like yourself has been good at breaking.
It's very scary. And it's interesting. I mean, it's very odd. You'd think that one would be scared of not giving the best performance that you can possibly give.
Right, yes.
You'd think that that would be the scary thing.
Mm.
But oddly, I find it isn't. What is scary is letting other people down.
Ah, right.
Drying, for example, in the middle of a scene.
Sure.
And you feel absolutely abject because you're letting the other person down.
Ah.
Whereas if you're doing something on your own, this is, you know, not everybody may feel like that.
Right.
But if you're doing something on your own and you're dry, I mean, it happened to me about 3 years ago, and I was doing one of the Alan Bennett, not mine, I'm too old for it now, but the Thor Heard one in theatre. And I completely dried.
The thing about you is you never stop. You just keep going. You're not ever going to retire. It's
I think it would be awful if I had to retire.
No.
Yes, but of course, you know, nature may well. Who knows? You know, I mean, this may go. I think it's going already, actually. But
No. I think you're somebody that's just never going to do that. And the good thing is, I think we're getting better at roles for people who aren't 18. Or
it's a bloody slow process, if that's the case. Yes, it really is. I mean, first of all, you know, it's beginning to get better now for women.
Right.
It's beginning.
Right.
And for kind of 50-year-olds, maybe, better and better and better, but it's slow. And for older... The thing I think that people forget is that the older you get, OK, you know, your looks change, you get, hopefully, a little wisdom along the way, but your feelings, if you love somebody, the feeling is still the same.
Yeah.
If you get very angry with somebody, the feeling is just the same. It's exactly the same.
Yeah.
It's just, it's tempered with, hopefully, a little wisdom that you've kind of, you know, clung to over the years.
Because you've amassed all this experience. I mean, this is, you're at your prime, really. You know, you get, but you are, all anybody who's like 60, 70, 80, beyond.
Yes.
As you said, amassed all this experience.
Yes.
It's crazy not to use that. Why wouldn't you
use
that?
Absolutely, absolutely. And the storylines. For particularly for women, but men, older men as well, of course. You know, there's a huge wealth.
Yeah.
There's a mine, a gold mine of stuff that people could write. I suppose because, you know, if you're a young writer, your experience of much older people, it would be your granny and grandpa.
Sure.
And, of course, you view them in a particular way.
Yeah.
So I suppose that's part of the reason, but that's not all of the reason. Mm. I think it's one of the last barricades that we need
to
fight.
You're right. Well, you look at shows like, you know, Last Tango. I mean, at least people are doing
it's wonderful.
It's brilliant. Well, more
absolutely.
Of that. Let's have more
Much
of that.
More.